Gin. Gin is liquor that derives its predominant flavor from juniper berries, Juniperus communis. Gin is one of the broadest categories of spirits, all of various origins, styles, and flavor profiles, that revolve around juniper as a common ingredient. From its earliest origins in the Middle Ages, the drink has evolved from a herbal medicine to an object of commerce in the spirits industry. Gin was developed based on the older Dutch liquor, jenever, and became popular in Great Britain, particularly in London, when William of Orange became King William III of England. The earliest known written reference to jenever appears in the 13th century encyclopaedic work Der Naturen Bloeme, Bruges, with the earliest printed recipe for jenever dating from 16th century work Een Constelijck Distileerboec, Antwerp. The physician Franciscus Silvius has been falsely credited with the invention of gin in the mid-17th century, although the existence of jenever is confirmed in Dean Philip Massinger's play The Duke of Milan, 1623, when Silvius would have been about 9 years old. It is further claimed that English soldiers who provided support in Antwerp against the Spanish in 1585, during the 80 Years' War, were already drinking jenever for its calming effects before battle, from which the term Dutch courage is believed to have originated. According to some unconfirmed accounts, gin originated in Italy. By the mid-17th century, numerous small Dutch and Flemish distillers had popularized the redistillation of malt spirit or malt wine with juniper, anise, caraway, coriander, etc., which were sold in pharmacies and used to treat such medical problems as kidney ailments, lumbago, stomach ailments, gallstones, and gout. Gin emerged in England in varying forms by the early 17th century, and at the time of the Restoration, enjoyed a brief resurgence. Gin became vastly more popular as an alternative to brandy, when William III, 2 and 1 and Mary II became co-sovereigns of England, Scotland and Ireland after leading the Glorious Revolution. Particularly in crude, inferior forms, where it was more likely to be flavored with turpentine. Gin drinking in England rose significantly after the government allowed unlicensed gin production, and at the same time imposed a heavy duty on all imported spirits such as French brandy. This created a larger market for poor quality barley that was unfit for brewing beer, and in 1695 to 1735 thousands of gin shops sprang up throughout England, a period known as the gin craze. Because of the low price of gin, when compared with other drinks available at the same time, and in the same geographic location, gin began to be consumed regularly by the poor. Of the 15,000 drinking establishments in London, not including coffee shops and drinking chocolate shops, over half were gin shops. Beer maintained a healthy reputation as it was often safer to drink the brewed ale than unclean plain water. Gin, though, was blamed for various social problems, and it may have been a factor in the higher death rates which stabilized London's previously growing population. The reputation of the two drinks was illustrated by William Hogarth in his engravings Beer Street and Gin Lane, 1751, described by the BBC as arguably the most potent anti-drug poster ever conceived. The negative reputation of gin survives today in the English language, in terms like gin mills or the American phrase gin joints to describe disreputable bars, or gin soak to refer to drunks. The epithet Mother's Ruin is a common British name for gin, the origin of which is the subject of ongoing debate. The Gin Act 1736 imposed high taxes on retailers and led to riots in the streets. The prohibitive duty was gradually reduced and finally abolished in 1742. The Gin Act 1751 was more successful, however, it forced distillers to sell only to licensed retailers and brought gin shops under the jurisdiction of local magistrates. Gin in the 18th century was produced in pot stills, and was somewhat sweeter than the London gin known today. In London in the early 18th century, much gin was distilled legally in residential houses. There were estimated to be 1,500 residential stills in 1726, and was often flavored with turpentine to generate resinous woody notes in addition to the juniper. As late as 1913, Webster's Dictionary states without further comment, common gin is usually flavored with turpentine. Another common variation was to distill in the presence of sulfuric acid. Although the acid itself does not distill, it imparts the additional aroma of diethyl ether to the resulting gin. Sulfuric acid subtracts 1 water molecule from 2 ethanol molecules to create diethyl ether, which also forms an azeotrope with ethanol, and therefore distills with it. The result is a sweeter spirit, and one that may have possessed additional analgesic or even intoxicating effects, see Paracelsus. Dutch or Belgian gin, also known as jenever or jenever, evolved from malt wine spirits, and is a distinctly different drink from later styles of gin. Schiedam, a city in the province of South Holland, is famous for its jenever producing history. The same for Hasselt in the Belgian province of Limburg. The oud, old, style of jenever remained very popular throughout the 19th century, where it was referred to as Holland or Geneva gin in popular, American, pre-prohibition bartender guides. The 18th century gave rise to a style of gin referred to as Old Tom gin, which is a softer, sweeter style of gin, often containing sugar. Old Tom gin faded in popularity by the early 20th century. The invention and development of the column still, 1826 and 1831, made the distillation of neutral spirits practical, thus enabling the creation of the Londonderry style that evolved later in the 19th century. In tropical British colonies, gin was used to mask the bitter flavor of quinine, which was the only effective antimalarial compound. Quinine was dissolved in carbonated water to form tonic water. The resulting cocktail is gin and tonic, although modern tonic water contains only a trace of quinine as a flavoring. Gin is a common base spirit for many mixed drinks, including the martini. Secretly produced bathtub gin was available in the speakeasies and blind pigs of Prohibition-era America as a result of the relative simple production. Slow gin is traditionally described as a liqueur made by infusing sloes, the fruit of the blackthorn, in gin, although modern versions are almost always compounded from neutral spirits and flavorings. Similar infusions are possible with other fruits, such as damsons or beech plums. Another popular gin-based liqueur with a long-standing history is Pimm's No. 1 Cup, 25% alcohol by volume, which is a fruit cup flavored with citrus and spices. The National Jenever Museums are located in Hasselt, Belgium, and Schiedam, the Netherlands. The name gin is a shortened form of the older English word jenever, related to the French word genever and the Dutch word jenever. All ultimately derived from juniperus, the Latin for juniper. Although several different styles of gin have evolved, it is legally differentiated into four categories in the European Union, which are described as follows. In the EU, the minimum bottled alcoholic strength for gin, distilled gin, and London gin is 37.5% ABV. In the United States, gin is defined as an alcoholic beverage of no less than 40% ABV, 80 proof, that possesses the characteristic flavor of juniper berries. Gin produced only through distillation or redistillation of aromatics with an alcoholic wash can be further distinguished and marketed as distilled gin. The Canadian Food and Drug Regulation recognizes gin with three different definitions: jenever, gin, London or dry gin, that loosely approximate the U.S. definitions. Whereas a more detailed regulation is provided for Holland gin or jenever, no distinction is made between compounded gin and distilled gin. Either compounded or distilled gin can be labeled as dry gin or London dry gin if it does not contain any sweetening agents. Some legal classifications define gin as only originating from specific geographical areas without any further restrictions, for example Plymouth gin, Ostfriesische Korn Genever, Slovenska Borovica, Kraski Brinjevec, etc., while other common descriptors refer to classic styles that are culturally recognized, but not legally defined, for example, Slow Gin and Old Tom Gin. Several different techniques for the production of gin have evolved since its early origins, this evolution being reflective of ongoing modernization in distillation and flavoring techniques. As a result of this evolution, gins can be broadly differentiated into three basic styles. Popular botanicals or flavoring agents for gin, besides the required juniper, often include citrus elements, such as lemon and bitter orange peel, as well as a combination of other spices, which may include any of anise, angelica root and seed, orris root, licorice root, cinnamon, almond, cubeb, savory, lime peel, grapefruit peel, dragon eye, longan, saffron, baobab, frankincense, coriander, grains of paradise, nutmeg, cassia bark or others. The different combinations and concentrations of these botanicals in the distillation process cause the variations in taste among gin products. Chemical research has begun to identify the various chemicals that are extracted in the distillation process and contribute to gin's flavoring. For example, juniper monoterpenes come from juniper berries. Citric flavors come from chemicals such as limonene and gamma-terpenene linalool. Spice-like flavors come from chemicals such as sabinine, delta-3-carine, and paracimine. According to the Canadian Food and Drug Regulation, gin is produced through redistillation of alcohol from juniper berries or a mixture of more than one sucre distilled food products. A well-known gin cocktail is the martini, traditionally made with gin and dry vermouth. Several other notable gin-based drinks include. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.